हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर सुनील राजौरिया फ्रॉम केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट MIIT मेरठ। इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल टेल यू अबाउट द इनर्ट गैस सिस्टम, इनर्ट गैस सिस्टम इन ऑयल टैंकर्स। फर्स्टली आई विल टेल यू ऑयल टैंकर्स कैरी ऑयल ऑफ डिफरेंट ग्रेड्स एंड क्वालिटीज हैविंग प्रॉपर्टीज टू प्रोड्यूस फ्लेमेबल वेपर्स एंड गैसेस व्हेन लोडेड फॉर transportation. Even with no cargo on board, there can be harmful flammable gases present in the hold. When the vapor produced by an oil cargo is mixed with certain concentration of air primarily containing oxygen, it can result in explosion, which results in damages to the property, marine pollution, and loss of life. For safety against such explosion, inert gas system is used on the board. It can be through as a separate inert gas plant or flue gas produced by ship's boiler. Inert gas system is the most important integrated system for oil tankers for safe operation of the ship. There are some following components which is used in the typical inert gas system in the oil tankers. Before going to the components of the inert gas system, I will tell you one more thing. The inert gas system speeds the inert gas over the oil cargo hydrocarbon mixture, which increases the lower explosion limits and simultaneously decreasing the higher explosion limits. When the concentration reaches around 10%, an atmosphere is created inside tank in which hydrocarbon vapors cannot burn. The concentration of inert gas is kept around 5% as a safety limit. One more thing, inert gas is the gas which contains insufficient oxygen, normally less than 8%, to suppress combustion of flammable hydrocarbon gases. Now, the following components are used in typical inert gas systems in oil tankers. First, exhaust gases source. This source is taken from exhaust uptakes of boiler or main engine as contains flue gases in it. Second one is inert gas isolating valve. It serves as the supply valve from uptake to the rest of the system, isolating both the system when not in use. Next one is scrubbing tower. In this tower, flue gas enters the scrub tower from bottom and passes through a series of water spray and baffle plates to cool, clean and moist the gases. SO2 level decreases up to 90% and gas becomes clear of soot. Next is damister, normally made of polypropylene. It is basically used to absorb moisture and water from the treated flue gas. Next is the gas blower. Normally two types of fan blowers are used: a steam driven turbine blower for inert gas operation, and second one is an electrically driven blower for topping up purpose. Next is inert gas pressing regulating valve. The pressure within the tanks varies with the property of oil and atmospheric condition. To control this variation and to avoid overheating of blower fan, a pressure regulator valve is attached after blower discharge, which recirculates the excess gas back to scrubbing tower. Next is mechanical non-return valve. It is an additional non-return mechanical device in line with the deck seal. Next is the deck isolating valve. The engine room system can be isolated fully with the deck system with the help of this valve. Next, pressure vacuum breaker. This breaker helps in controlling the over or under pressurization of cargo tanks. This pressure vacuum breaker vent is fitted with frame trap to avoid fire to ignite when loading or discharging operation is going on when in port. Next is the cargo tank isolating valves. A vessel has number of cargo holds and each hole is provided with an isolating valve. The valve controls the flow of inert gas to hold and is operated only by a responsible officer in the vessel. Next is the musterizer. The musterizer is used to maintain a positive pressure of inert gas at the time of loading of cargo, and during the loading time it is kept open to avoid pressurization of cargo tank. The last one is the safety and alarm system. This is very important. The inert gas plant is provided with various safety features to safeguard the tank and its own machinery. So these are the various components of the inert gas systems. Okay, thank you.